Hey, what's up, Team No? Hey, what's up, Team No Guard? Baz here. We actually have another channel recording right beside us because we have with us Monarch,
I don't
who is a Toronto World Championship qualifier. Winner! Winner! What's that, can you guess? Immortal Sakura Kaiser. He did it.
I don't understand myself, but it worked.
So for those of you who haven't seen it already, we do have this on the channel, but we're going to do it one more time.
All right, hey guys, it's Grand Professor Cardfighters, and as Matt said earlier, we're going to show you a deck profile. This is the first deck profile that we have on my channel, so yeah, let's get started.
Okay, so great zero.
All right, starter, Raichu. This is going to be extremely important. For those who don't know, you will see why I don't want to spoil surprise.
Okay, great one.
Triggers.
Oh, yeah, definitely triggers.
All right, standard. 8 crit. 4 draw. 4 heal. Nothing special.
This is a super aggro deck, though. Why aren't you running 16 crit? Or even 12 crit?
Draws have helped me, and honestly, it's mostly because I thought team is better.
GG against me in round 4, and that was just icing on the cake.
Great one. Right, Jay. These are pretty much the center of the deck.
You want to draw those every time.
Yeah. Which I almost did every game. Almost.
I still claim you have done some magical voodoo ritual that you draw it every time.
Again, it wasn't every time, but it was close. Alright, perfect art. Any will do. This is one of each different than no one have right now.
Do you have an OG perfect art there?
Right there.
That's beauty.
Yeah, so it doesn't matter perfect art, the name doesn't matter in the damage zone, so just go nuts. Four. Bear their own samurai.
What is that?
Alright, basically, it's for the new Ashura support that was released in EV08. The ability is, as long as I have a banner of Ashura in its name, every time during my battle phase, the unit stands, plus 3000 power. You will see where this comes in when we hit the pretty soon. But first, the pretty two. Save this one for later, because 10k vanillas, doesn't matter what you want. I've just been running this because I can. I even had the third Jupiter, but Rook has been playing work, so just keep it there. Or Daredevil Samurai. Same effect as this Samurai, so...
So you have 8 targets in your deck for the stupidness that will come.
Yes. And for the last of the 3-2s, 1 Cloud Booter. Just 1.
Why 1?
Because that's all you need.
Why is it all you need though?
Because of the ride chain. When we ride the grade 1, we get the 2 for free. And as you can see, there's only 8 grade 2s, so this is extremely needed.
There we go.
The grade 3s. The 1 Stern, because it's there. 4 regular Ashura. Amazing backup.
That should actually won the game.
That actually beat me.
2-1-2 got beat with straight up Ashura over Break Ride.
He hits a crit.
No, 1-turn-1 Break Ride. I didn't win the Break Ride turn. For the 4-month Break Ride?
Stupid fun of the deck.
Immortal Ashura Kaiser.
What does it do?
Well, I limit break. If you drag her to grade 3, at the end of battle, attack the Vanguard. This is very important if you have to beat the blend deals with this thing. Counterblast 2, start 2 Nova Grapplers, choose your Vanguard, choose a rear guard, stand them, and Ashura needs 10,000 power. Now, one, it's a cross ride, so that's always nice.
Doesn't matter what it is.
This is what makes the deck stupid. Bond Love. This is the card you want to get.
So show us the combo.
Alright, but before you, I'll explain what this does. It's a break ride, plus 10, gain skill to the Vanguard. When your Vanguard attacks their Vanguard, Terrorblast 1, stand all your rear guards.
Now show them the stupid combo that makes them
and
every
stupid
game.
Numbers.
That makes me cringe.
This
like
is
it.
Why we don't want to face them at locals.
Yeah.
Anyone wants to face me.
I don't mind it.
I have a winning record at locals.
I'll try it.
Yeah, you don't mind it. You're playing Glendia.
All they took your players, you don't have to shit your pants. It's fine.
That's still hard.
Rubidium's a good card.
So, why don't you set up facing the other way? So you know what? Let's put it up with the optimal field.
Let's not go that far.
Realistic.
No. You had that. No, I need a one back here for fully optimal.
Yeah, he didn't have a beard and timber behind him. Yeah, of course.
Alright, so this is reasonable field that you get. Alright, your turn, you have 4 damage, you break ride, it's over.
It's over. Forgot.
Alright, 15. Easy number. 18. Easy number. 26, break right skill, all redirect stand, plus 15,000 power, plus 15,000 power.
Cool. And if you have two standbys on each side.
Yeah, any unit.
This is like a Mr. Invincible.
Alright, so let's say your drive check is this, whatever, grade 3. Game over.
Essentially lose now.
Limerick skill, Cannon Blast 2, Ditch 2. You drive checking your own cost, so as long as you have Cannon Blast, you're good. Mortal Restands, plus 10, Samurai Stand number 3, because it counts the Vanguard standing as well. So this becomes 33, this becomes 36, this is now also 36, you Cannon Blast 1 for Break Right again, and Restand all the Redirects, 15, 15. And then you Twin Drive again. Plus crit, plus crit. So,
so that was the deck.
Yeah.
Once again, Monarch with Team Noguard's newest member, just to let you know. And remember, words are hard, SPs are sexy, and later days.